Today I am going to give you a lecture on ring theory. This is the definition of ring. Let R be any non-empty set with two binary operations, addition and multiplication. It's called a ring if it satisfies the following properties. The very first property is R plus is an abelian group. And as we know that for abelian group we require five properties. The very first property is closure property. Means if you choose any two element A and A comma B belongs to R, definitely their sum like A plus B is again member of R. The second property is associative property. If you choose any three arbitrary element ABC which belong to a non-empty set R, this property A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. And the third property is known as existence of identity element. For every A element which belongs to R, there exists a particular element which is 0, such that A plus 0 is equal to 0, A plus 0 is equal to A, and at the same time 0 plus A is also A. And this shows 0 is the additive identity of set R. Next property is existence of inverse. For every A member which belongs to R, there exists a negative of that element which is minus of A. So when we add A and minus A, we get additive identity which is 0. And the next property is commutative property. Means for any two arbitrarily chosen A and B element which belongs to R, we always have A plus B is equal to B plus A. And this property is known as commutative property. So if our non-empty set R possesses these five properties for additive operation, and the second property is associative property for multiplication. R must possess the associative property for multiplication, means A dot B dot C is equal to A dot B dot C. This is associative property for multiplicative operation. And the third important property, which is distributive laws held in R, the right and left distributive laws are as such, A dot B plus C gives us A dot B plus A dot C. And for left distributive law, B plus C into A gives us BA plus CA. So if any non-empty set R which satisfy these three important criteria, means R must form an abelian group for additive operation, and for multiplication R must possess the associative property, and the third important property is distributive law. So any non-empty set having these three important property is known as ring. The next definition is ring with unity. See, a ring with unity is a ring having a multiplicative identity element. Previously, in the definition of ring, we have identity element as 0, and which is additive identity. But suppose your ring possesses a multiplicative identity, and usually multiplicative identity is 1. So any ring which possesses a multiplicative identity is known as ring with unity. Next definition is commutative ring. A ring which possesses a commutative property for multiplication operation means A dot B is equal to B dot A. Previously in the definition of ring we have commutative property, but it is for, that is for additive operation. If some ring possesses a commutative property for a multiplicative operation, then such ring is known as a commutative ring. The next definition is ring with zero divisor. A ring R is said to be a ring with zero divisor if for any two non-zero elements we have A dot B is equal to 0. Usually for real number it is not true, because the product of two non-zero number is not equal to, is not implies A dot B is equal to 0. But here we have A dot B equal to 0 for ring with zero divisor, and usually such things happen in the case of matrix multiplication. For example, we consider two matrices like A matrix which is of 2 into 2 order, 1, 0, 0, 0, and the other matrix is suppose B, and which is 0, 0, 0, 1. Individually both the matrices are non-zero matrices because all the elements of A are non-zero. So A individually non-zero matrix, B is also non-zero matrix, but when we multiply them, if you multiply these two matrices A and B, their product gives us a zero matrix. So this is true for matrix multiplication. And similar operation we will find in addition modulo or a multiplication modulo. For example, suppose we consider a multiplication modulo property. Let us consider a multiplication modulo 6. And we choose two elements 3 and 2. Where 3 and 2 are individually non-zero numbers, but when we operate a multiplication modulo 6 between these two elements, the product will be 0 according to the addition multiplication modulo 6 property. So whenever our product is equal to or greater than modulo number 6, we divide with 6 and we put the remainder. So 3 and 2 are individually non-zero numbers, but their product gives us 0. This shows a zero divisor property. So all such rings whose two non-zero element when multiplied gives us 0 is known as a ring with zero divisor. The next definition is ring without zero divisor. In this, a ring R is said to be a ring without zero divisor if the product of two elements is equal to 0, implies either A0 or B0. At least one element should be a 0, then only we get A dot B is equal to 0, and with this property ring is known as ring without zero divisor. The next definition is integral domain. The integral domain is again a ring, is said to be a integral domain D plus dot with two binary operation addition and multiplication if it is commutative ring with unity and without zero divisor. So any ring which possesses three property means a commutative ring with unity and without zero divisor. A ring with these three properties known as integral domain. Now the next definition is field. Now we can easily define this field in two different manner. The field is basically F plus shows an abelian group. F multiplication also form an abelian group, and distributive law holds in F. Then the set F is known as field, or there is an alternative definition, or in other words, a field can be defined as a commutative ring with unity is said to be a field if every non-zero element of F possesses a multiplicative inverse. A division ring or a skew field. The skew field is slightly different from our field. A ring R with a unity is said to be a division ring if every non-zero element of F possesses a multiplicative inverse. Means there is no commutative property for multiplicative operation. So if we put one more property to the division ring or a skew field, which is multiplicative commutative property, then the skew field becomes a field. And the next definition is characteristics of a ring. The characteristic of a ring R is defined as the smallest positive number and such that n dot a is 0 for every a belongs to R. For any arbitrary chosen element a belongs to R, if there exists a smallest positive integer n such that n dot a is equal to 0, such number n is known as characteristic of ring R. And if there is no such positive integer exists, then the ring R is said to be a ring with zero characteristic. Therefore, R is of characteristic 0 if n dot a is not equal to 0 for every a belongs to R. Let us consider an example of characteristic of ring. If you consider an I6, which consists of 6 integer values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. These are the 6 members which belongs to a set I6. And the ring I6 with addition modulo 6, multiplication modulo 6 has the characteristic 6, because if we choose 6, if we choose any element which belongs to I6 and we multiply, suppose we multiply 6 with 0, definitely it produces 0. If you multiply 6 with 1, 6 into 1 gives us 6, and because it is multiplication modulo 6, so again we divide 6 with 6 and we put the remainder, which is 0. If you multiply 6 with 2, 6 with 12, but 12 is again greater than 6, so we divide 12 by 6 and we put the remainder 0 again. So for every member which belongs to I6, we have 6 into a multiplication modulo 6 into x gives us 0 for every member x which belongs to I6. This shows the characteristic for this I6 ring is 6. So the next definition is subring. Any non-empty subset, let us consider a ring R with binary operation addition and multiplication. If we consider any subset as any non-empty subset as of a ring R, is called a subring if S itself form a ring for the induced operation. Means for the same binary operation addition and multiplication, if S itself form a ring, then S is called a subring of ring R. Now, improper subring. Every ring possesses two subrings, namely the ring R itself and a zero ring. Except these two rings, if there exists any other ring, then such rings are called a proper ring. Otherwise, R and 0 both are namely improper subrings of R. So, for proper subring, we have a definition of a subring S of a ring R is called a proper subring of R if and only if S is not equal to R, means S is not equal to ring and S is not equal to 0 ring. Any other ring except S, R and 0 is called proper subring of R. Subdomain, any non-empty subset D dash of an integral domain. If you consider an integral domain D plus dot, and if there exists a subset D dash of D plus dot, and this D dash again form an integral domain for the same induced operation addition and multiplication, then such subset D dash of D is known as subdomain. Similarly, we have subfield for field. Any non-empty subset F dash of a field F plus dot is called a subfield of F plus dot if and only if F dash itself form a field with respect to induced operation. The next definition is prime field. A field is called a prime field if it contains no proper subfield. That is, if it has no subfield other than itself. Now we come to definition of left ideal and right ideal. If we consider a ring R, then any non-empty subset S of ring R is said to be a left ideal if it possesses two properties. The very first property is S must form an additive subgroup of R, means S form an additive subgroup of R. And the second property, for any member R which belongs to ring R and any member S which belongs to S, RS belongs to S. Means we multiply a ring element from left hand side to the element of S, and if the resulting element which is RS again belongs to S, then the S is known as a left ideal. Similarly, in case of right ideal, a non-empty subset S of a ring R is called a right ideal of R if you multiply this ring element from right hand side to the element S which belongs to capital S, and if the resulting element SR again belongs to S, and S is also additive subgroup of R, then we say S is the right ideal of R. And now we define an ideal. A non-empty subset S of a ring R is called an ideal or two-sided ideal if it possesses both the properties of left ideal as well as right ideal. Means S is an additive subgroup of R, and if we choose one arbitrary element R which belongs to capital R and small s which belongs to capital S, and their product RS and SR, means we multiply ring element from left or right side, both the elements RS and SR again belongs to S, then this S become an ideal. And here we have two remarks for the ideals. A left ideal of S and a left ideal S of a commutative ring is always a right ideal. Why it is so? Because for a commutative ring, it always possesses a commutative property. And so RS and SR become seen. That's why a left ideal S of a ring R is right ideal. And second remark is an ideal S of a ring R is a subring of R. Means ideal of a ring always form a subring. Now, improper and proper ideals, let R plus dot be a ring and the ideal R and 0 are called improper ideal of R. Any other ideal other than R and 0 is called a proper ideal. Further, we have unit and zero ideals. Let R plus dot be a ring and the ideal R and 0 are called the unit and zero ideal. Simple ring, a ring is called a simple ring if it has no proper ideal, then it is known as simple ring. Now we define a principal ideal. An ideal of a ring R is called a principal ideal if it is generated by a single element of ring. Principal ideal ring, a ring R is said to be a principal ideal ring if each and every ideal of ring R is a principal ideal. And the final definition, principal ideal domain. An integral domain is called a principal ideal domain if its every ideal is principal ideal. Prime ideal, an ideal S of a ring R is called a prime ideal of R if A dot B belongs to S implies A belongs to S or B belongs to S. If any ideal will satisfy this condition, for product of two element A dot B belongs to S, this implies A belongs to S or B belongs to S. Such ideals are called a prime ideals. Now we come to the definition of maximal ideal. If S is properly contained in R, suppose we have ring R plus dot and S is an ideal of ring R. An ideal S of a ring R is called a maximal ideal of R if it possesses two properties. The first, the S is properly contained in R, means S is a subset of R, that is S contained in R and S is not equal to R. Secondly, this, if we consider another ideal, suppose we consider another ideal S dash which contains ideal S, and this implies either S dash is equal to R or S dash coincides with S. In both the cases, if an ideal satisfies both the conditions, such ideals are known as maximal ideal. Next, a quotient ring. Let S be an ideal of a ring R, then R by S denote the family of cosets. R by S is a family of cosets like S plus A, where A belongs to R and S is any ideal of ring R. Then we choose two arbitrary elements, for example S plus A, S plus B, or any two arbitrary element of R by S, and define an operation of addition and multiplication of R by S as follows. If we add two cosets of ideal S, which is S plus A, S plus B, in this particular manner, like S plus S become S, S being a subring ideal. So S plus A plus B. And if you product two cosets S plus A and S plus B in such a manner, if it is equal to S plus AB, then R by S is a ring with above operation. For these two defined operations, if R by S itself form a ring, then such rings are known as a quotient ring or a factor ring, or sometimes it is known as a different ring or a difference ring or a residue class ring. Now, ring homomorphism, a mapping F from a ring R to another ring R dash. Any mapping F which is from one ring to another ring R dash, if it satisfies the two properties, one for addition and the other one for multiplication. Means if we operate F over sum of two elements of which belongs to R, like F of A plus B gives us FA plus FB. At the same time, for multiplication, we find F of AB is equal to FA, FB. For every AB belongs to R. Any mapping which satisfies these two conditions is called a ring homomorphism. The next definition is ring isomorphism. Let us consider a mapping R which is from one ring R to another ring R dash, and if F satisfies all these three criteria, means F is 1, 1, means for each distinct element of R, we have distinct element in R dash. And onto means each element of R dash possesses a pre-image in R. And third property is homomorphism. Means if you operate F over A plus B, gives us FA plus FB. And if you operate F over a product of two elements of ring R, A and B, F of AB gives us FA, FB. For every AB belongs to R. So any mapping which satisfies these three properties, 1-1, onto and homomorphism. Such mappings are known as isomorphisms. Now we discuss properties of ring isomorphism. If F is an isomorphism of a ring R onto a ring R dash, then F of 0 gives us 0 dash. Here, this 0 is basically a 0 element of ring R, while 0 dash is the 0 element for R dash. And if you operate F over a negative of ring element, like minus of A, then it gives us minus of FA, for every A belongs to R. An isomorphic image of commutative ring is again a commutative ring. An isomorphic image of ring with unity is again a ring with unity. Isomorphic image of integral domain is again an integral domain. And the final, which is isomorphic image of a field, is again a field. And isomorphic image of a skew field is again a skew field. Let us define a kernel of a ring homomorphism. Let F be a homomorphism of a ring R into a ring R dash. Then the set K of all those elements of ring R which mapped on the identity element of R dash means collection of all those elements of ring which mapped on identity element of R dash, which is 0 dash. And clearly this K is not equal to 5, because at least 0 belongs to R. We know that F of 0 is always 0 dash. So at least one element is there, so K is not equal to 5. So if F be a homomorphism of a ring R into R dash, then the set K of all those elements of R which are mapped onto the 0 element of R dash is called the kernel of homomorphism, and it is denoted by a capital K. Symbolically, K is kernel F, which includes all those elements X which belongs to R whose image is equal to 0 dash.